you and your managers have the courage to demonstrate humility. We're going to look at why this is important, then give you three practical ways you can put this into action. First, the why. Jocko Willink, former Navy SEAL and leadership guru, says humility is the number one characteristic of any leader. Scientific studies show that there is a connection between our humility and the team's performance and our own happiness. So let's help our people be happy and enjoy the productivity gains. Maybe that's too modern for you, so let's go all the way back to St. Augustine, who gave three pieces of advice to a student when he said, the first part is humility, the second, humility, the third, humility, and this I would continue to repeat as often as you might ask direction. Even Buddha said that our attachment to our views and opinions is a particular source of human suffering. So three ways to throw this into action. Number one, invite contrarian views in the next discussion. Make sure that you're getting alternative perspectives and don't let people out of the room until we've at least wrestled down one alternative view. Second, take this as a definition of humility. Tim Keller once said, humility is not thinking less of ourselves. It's thinking of ourselves less. So you can make it a checklist item for your leaders that they have thought through what the implications for others are, that they have asked for, solicited, and found the perspectives of others as they're making decisions, taking actions. Last thing, in your next small group meeting or one-to-one, ask this question: how can I be a better boss? It doesn't matter what the response is, you will have something to work on. In some cases, people have just been dying to tell you something and they're going to come right out with what you need to work on to be a better boss. And that will give you something to work on immediately. You might get silence. And if you get total silence, that's an answer because it tells you you need to build trust so that it can share that feedback with you. Use that question over and over again so that people know it's safe to share that information. You get something to work on. It'll demonstrate humility, which benefits you and the entire team. We hope this helps you be a better and more purposeful leader.